I'll pick it up and show you a thing. You watch. If I pick this up by that there, that's an Aboriginal person's skull bone. This is what I want to protect. It's our ancient people's burials and stuff. And I don't want nobody touching these people. That's too important. That's turned to stone. That's how long he's been here.
Hello, this is The Point. Later tonight, Indigenous Affairs front and centre. The opposition leader takes the latest Aboriginal senator on the road as politicians across the country gear up for the federal election. But first, the shortlist for a national nuclear waste facility has come down to one site, Barndioota in South Australia's Flinders Ranges. The issue is dividing the residents of the nearby town of Hawker. The Adnamutna traditional owners say that the proposed site contains thousands of artefacts, and The Point can exclusively reveal that there are also ancient Aboriginal remains. Laura Murphy-Oates with this story.
This land could become the future home for Australia's nuclear waste. Adnamutna woman Regina McKenzie lives on the property next door. Her land is an Indigenous protected area set aside by the Australian government as a place of environmental and cultural significance. But she says that doesn't stop at the fence.
This is how much archaeology I'm talking about.
Scattered on the ground, ancient spear tips, grindstones and hearths, the remnants of Adnamutna life through the ages. Lying just nearby, an amazing discovery.
If I pick this up by that there, that's an Aboriginal person's skull bone. This is what I want to protect. It's our ancient people's burials and stuff. And I don't want nobody touching these people. That's too important. That's turned to stone. That's how long he's been here.
Regina has always known these remains were here. A report from state government forensic experts confirms the bone is most likely an ancient Aboriginal skull. Just how old is yet to be determined. This artefact scatter is just one of two sites on the property that have been registered as an Aboriginal heritage site with the South Australian government. A few minutes' drive away is this sacred waterhole.
We're actually sitting on the storyline. This is Bungapurana. The rocks behind us, that represents a girl's skin. The water represents her birth water. The whole 70 kilometres right down to the lake, just all the way is full of artefacts, archaeology. We've got cave paintings around the corner. We've got archaeology all up through everything. We've got rock carving up in on that hill. We've got graves.
These sites sit on the Wallabadina property in Barndioota, 30 kilometres out from the town of Hawker in the iconic Flinders Ranges. It's Crown land, owned by the state government, but leased to former Liberal Senator Grant Chapman. Last November, Mr. Chapman voluntarily nominated the site to store nuclear waste, and it was put on a shortlist of six sites nationwide. Now that list has narrowed down to one, Wallabadina.
The waste for this is a national facility just for Australian waste. And that point, I think, has been made clearly through the community consultation. So Australian waste, low-level waste for disposal, intermediate-level waste for storage.
Dr. Griffiths says the low-level waste will become safe in a few hundred years. However, there is no current plan for where the toxic intermediate-level waste will eventually go, which has Hawker residents concerned. Last Friday, more than 100 people, about a third of the town's population, gathered in town to hear the government's plan. The government says the facility will only be built if the community want it. And whilst polling earlier this year showed broad support, many feel their voices haven't been heard.
I'm Adnyamatna Elder, and this yarta that we're talking about, land, the mudda, the dream time that runs through there, is very strong. It's alive and well.
I don't want South Australia to be known as the place of a dump.
We're not asking for that stuff here.
They breached Australian standards at Maralinga. I don't trust them to meet strict Australian standards here.
What do Aboriginal people in end get out of it? Nothing.
But not everyone was opposed.
I live in Hawker, John Hennessy's my name. I'm going to put my head on the chopping block and say I support this proposal.
This will put employment into the town forever. We're talking about a project that's going to run for, 300 years or whatever. Like, it's an enormous project. There's enormous amounts of money involved. And we're we're honoured to be able to receive it if it goes ahead.
We have to find a solution for it Australia-wide. We've been trying to for 30 years. This time the government and the opposition agreed that we would ask landholders to nominate, and then we would consult with the community to see if we could find one that wanted it. And that's what this process is.
The government are promising 15 to 20 jobs. They've also announced a $2 million community benefit package to be distributed amongst the community, regardless of whether the site ends up here. And if the project goes ahead, it will also provide another $10 million. General store owner Brendan Bevan says that money could radically alter the future of this small rural community.
The capital injection into a small town like Hawker, that could equate to certainly other jobs and development. I mean, heck, if we could develop our little shop as it was, we'd certainly be needing people to, you know, we could further employ two or three staff members.
He says many he's spoken to in the town are supportive, but there's still a lot of questions.
I think we'd be silly not to entertain it as an option with an understanding of what that means. Are we tying ourselves into something?
According to the region's mayor, it's not just those in town that are supportive. He says many farmers and landowners are keeping an open mind.
For the most part, they are a little bit ambivalent. I don't think the ones I've spoken to have a great level of concern about what this is going to do to their properties or to their land values.
Everyone we speak to, all the neighbours, are totally dead against it. Yeah, they just don't want it here.
John Gill is the owner of Myrna Myrna Station. He shares 10 kilometres of fence line with the nominated property. He fears that phobia around nuclear waste will affect the price of his stock and the local tourism industry.
It's going to affect everything up here. It's going to be known as the Hawker Dump. When it gets dry and tough up here, tourism is what we live on. And if we lose that, we lose a big chunk of our livelihood.
He also has big questions about the environmental impacts into the future.
How the hell are they going to maintain that facility for 300 years? They can't give us that guarantee. They just can't do it.
But John says the town is being bought off.
In a 30k, 40k radius of this site, there's probably only 35, 40 of us living out here. There's 100 living in Hawker. It doesn't take much to get the numbers, you know, when they're hanging a big carrot over the town.
Indigenous leaders agree.
It will sway people because, you know, it's like a carrot dangling. I mean, money talks. It's a kick in the guts. I mean, $2 million, when you weigh that all up, I mean, our fires are going to spread. I mean, there's projects, and we bring $133 million into the region through tourism. And what's $2 million?
The next stage of the project will involve a range of technical assessments on the site, including an independent cultural heritage survey in consultation with the Adnamutna people. But Regina already knows the site's value, and she wants the whole project binned.
I'm hoping it doesn't go to courts. I'm hoping that they just get up and leave. But if they push, I'm not backing down. Neither is the Adnamutna people.